Boa!
Mai honima, tiki ie fukaki he maolu mataha. Hoi pili o te, yoko whaka ilunga. Ma te maa tonga pē, ki he auha. Pou pou mai, taata alo hofu ka. Disco mai, opa pou a teke maa. Pou pou mai, taata alo hofu ka. Disco mai, pea ke hiki honima. Kuma te maa tonga, kuma te maa tonga pē.
Yeah.
Oua.
Mai honi ma, tiki ie fukaki he maolunga saha. Foipili o te, yoko whaka ilunga. Ma te maa tonga pē, ki he auha. Pou pou mai, ta ata alo hofu ka, disco mai. Opa pou a teke ma, pou pou mai. Ta ata alo hofu ka, disco mai. Pea ke hiki honi ma. Ku ma te maa tonga, ku ma te maa tonga pē.
We might see if we can get the team list up on the screen for the people at home. We're already tuning in on Netball Australia TV, right across the Pacific and around the globe. Probably the big talking point is Annabelle Laurie, the captain of USC Thunder, has not been able to get here today. She's got caught up and has had to withdraw from the game, so that'll be a big loss for Thunder.
I think that I learned that early, leaving home to bypass the traffic here. First ball, centre pass to USC.
So we are underway. And referee gives the whistle there, and Bryce gets the game going. Mukunde in at goal attack, and it's going to be a free pass for Metcalf into Martin. Martin on the edge of the circle, looking to feed. And Lee Jones will have a shot from range to kick us off, and she gets one back, goes to Mukunde. And no, referee said it will stay with Mukunde. And she can't get the second chance at it, and Trongatala come away. So Veve, who's been impressive, Koloto, and down to
Palavi.
Yeah.
Combination there today at the shooters is Unique Palavi and Mika Koloto.
Yeah, and Palavi's been impressive also in the tournament so far. And well, Delaney there trying to get in and block, but gets penalised. So Tonga first team on the board. USC looking for their opening points. Martin's got to come back down the court, and that one's nearly picked off. So McClure goes to Bryce, and now Lee Jones, and back out to Bryce, and that's contested, almost taken away by Yongi. That was good defensive work.
It was, and Lee Jones, I noticed that they've been playing her. She's now in the shooters, but yesterday she had played defense for them. So she can really play both ends.
Yeah, they had her during the game. She had up the front and goal shooter and goal defence. They had her at both ends of the court in the game yesterday or the day before.
Three balls into court, coming out again.
Koloto took it further away for Palavi. Probably made the shot a little bit more difficult, but Delaney's given up the penalty, and Palavi rolls it in. Bryce looking for the pass. They only got the 3 seconds. Goes to McClure. She finds Bryce again. And long pass down to Lee Jones. The opening came.
The Tonga defence there, Tala defence there, Lose Whanganuku came out doing some hunting there, leaving Lee Jones there at home alone, which gave her that advantage.
Yeah, and it was good vision from the USC team to pick her out in the goal circle. Wing attack there is Setafano.
Cool.
USC take the turnover, and they're going to give it straight back. Well, Palavi was going in hard to get it from Delaney, but a little bit of contact, so free pass for Delaney. Oh, nearly picked off the game there on the pass back. McClure, centre court. And having to be very physical there, Martin can't pull it down. Palavi laid it off. She'll want it back. They're going to try and step back in, get a couple of passes, and that one picked up.
Good one, and she was able to get that back, Julita, for the Tongatala. Oh, untimely pass there from Stefano. Just got to settle the nerves there, I guess, for both teams.
Bebe trying to pick one off. That ball's going to run off the court.
We also have to have our eyes on the ball tonight, Mike.
We're down courtside for everyone at home. We've been up the back of the grandstand, and now we're right down courtside. We're right close to the action. I'm loving it down here.
It is. It's a different sight altogether up here. Best seat in the house.
You can really see the physicality of the players, their athleticism and the speed of the game up close is quite phenomenal. Well, Bryce goes over to Lee Jones and she pulls it in. Shot from range, drops it in. Well, Thunder to the lead now, 4-3. It turns around pretty quickly.
It does. 4-3, USC lead. Tala having their hands on the ball at the moment.
Colotto will nice lead over to Palavi. Climbing high. Metcalf had to go up for that one. And picked off in the back. And Metcalf almost gets one back.
Good defense there from Lose Fanganuku. Tonga's goalkeeper who managed to steal that one away from USC.
Bebe happy to come wide and
some good eyes there from Vika Coloto.
Yeah, Bebe saw Coloto down the right side and then that just opened up the space for Palavi to get the pass.
It did.
Well, they look along again and Metcalf went in for it. I think it'll go. I think contact by Metcalf on the way to try and steal on Stefano.
And I think Stefano saw that and she just stood still.
She braced herself.
She just paced herself right there.
Yeah, Metcalf sort of went in over the top of the leg. And
it was one of those run into me.
I'm going to be the concrete pillar and you're going to come off second best. Lee Jones down the court. Gets back into the goal circle and had a bit of contact there. Our two referees today, Justin Barnes and Nathan Begley. Well, that's wonderful scramble from both teams.
Great really. Hustle there from Tonga's goalkeeper, Lose Fanganuku.
Yeah, it's just they absolute prize the possession and they want to take every single ball they can off the opponent. Nongi and the lead came and she went into Vevi and Vevi goes over to Palavi and all those connections are very strong in the Tongan team.
It is, and we can see that the Tongantala are warming up there but still getting a good challenge from USC. Tonga leads 7-4.
Free pass there for Tonga. Palavi drops it in. Little slap of the hands there on her teammate in the goal circle there, Colotta. They're working well together.
Ooh, good defense there. Oh. Once again, Lose Fanganuku.
Yeah, she's reading it well from the back.
Ooh.
And Delaney did well just to spoil, but Bevy regained the possession, and that one a little bit long for Palavi. Again. This is being played at extremely high tempo, and that one long, and Lee Jones went for it.
The pressure of defense when that happens from the opposition, and it gives pressure making those untimely calls.
Yes. Yeah. Those snap decisions you've got to make with movement all around you and space and looking for your players. That one long. Colotto did well to put it in.
Hard luck on USC wing defense there.
Well, I think it was flicked back in by Colotto and then knocked out. That's probably good gamesmanship to throw it back into the opposition and so they take it out. Pallavi steps away from the defence and she'll let another one. So Tonga now stretching them at 9-4, 6:20 to go. So I've had a couple of changes of the lead here in this game so far in the first quarter. Picked off by Metcalf and cleaned up by Martin. And Bryce needs to get rid of it. Time was ticking. Victor's into Lee Jones. So we've got Richter's has come in with Mukundi going off the court.
Never there.
Martin at the Richter's and Richter's gets back into the goal circle. She might chat. Oh no, she goes over the top to Lee Jones, who couldn't control it, but it was last touched by Fanganuku.
Defense there for Tonga, Fanganuku and Los Fifita together with Claire Yongi at wing defense, and that's a great combination there. As you can see, they managed to turn over that ball.
Yeah, Fanganuku, I think, has got at least 5 steals so far in the first quarter. She's on absolutely on fire.
She first played for Tala in July qualifiers. She's really making her mark.
So she's only a very new player in the team.
She is a new player in the team since July, but she's not new to netball. She's got quite some netball history back in New Zealand, so very fortunate, and we could see her talent coming through there.
Sure, and certainly making a mark here in the Tongan side at defence, and she's making the life of Lee Jones quite difficult.
Lasafanga Nuku, she's from a family of a whole lot of sports people. Her brother plays for the All Blacks, and her other brother plays for the Tongan Ikaletahi rugby team. So
right.
You could see it runs through the family there.
Yeah, well, the name is familiar that I know through rugby. So, that's a nice connection. Very sporting family.
Family right there.
So she's based in New Zealand then?
She is based in New Zealand. Christchurch. Hard luck there for Tonga. Did not go in that shoot, so they'll work twice as hard if they could turn that over. USC with the ball now. Tonga lead 11-6.
And I'm trying to get a feed into the circle. Might have to come out around the top. Richter's goes over the top to Lee Jones, who's a very tall target. And she puts it away.
I said it's very rare that you have someone playing the way that they've played Lee Jones, very impressive.
Court,
exactly.
Yeah.
And they could do that because she has the height. And, she was playing, I noticed that how she played gold shoot and then gold keep, and today gold shoot again.
Yeah, so when she goes to the other end of the court, she's just got to remember what...
which position
she's
playing.
She's gone, she doesn't turn around and have a shot at the... steals one in defense and turns
I do. I do remember one of the netball coaches and the line that came from there was, you can teach skills, but you can't teach height. And I
yeah, true.
You know?
Yep.
And I think that's a real, in terms of Lee Jones there, she's really got the height and the physique to play the positions.
Well, we've seen it so far in the tournament where the players with that physical presence, like Pallavi, can really just hold position in under the post, and that's going to be one for her partner there in Koloto.
Koloto is able to move around now. I see both defenders of USC doubling up on Pallavi.
Yeah, and Pallavi, extremely accurate. She doesn't miss many.
She doesn't. Pallavi de Fotonga, 13 14 to 8 USC.
Inside the final 2 minutes of the first quarter, and Martin comes out to the right hand side, and I'll come back to Martin in the center, and that's almost spoiled there by Yongi. Martin now fakes the pass in. She needs to get rid of it. I'll come back to Martin. She's looking for Lee Jones, and we've had a contact in the circle, so it's going to be Lee Jones will have the shot. Well, Peter had to come in and help there because he's looking for releases. Serafano goes over to Colotto. And another one on the board. Oh, lovely.
Some good eyes there, seeing that the shooter was there and just available, ready.
Yeah, that came from a long way down the court. That was an absolute rocket pass. Palavi won't need any help, just drops in, makes it look easy.
Saw the defender there doing a little bit of swimming up in the air, trying to defend that ball off Palavi. Whoa.
Oh, Vevi getting into the lane there, couldn't control it, but nice spoiling play. And Martin goes over, and the long arms of Lee Jones takes it away from Wanganuku and gets another goal. So last couple of seconds here of the quarter, 16-11. It's been an entertaining first stanza. And I don't know if Tonga are going to get there. They're happy just to close out the game or close out the quarter and go to the break there at 16-11 to the lead. Well, Whanganuku, for me, has impressed at the back. And
I think she would be the player of this quarter here, Whanganuku, really making her mark. She's stolen a few balls, if we counted 5 to 6.
Yeah, absolutely. She's been
turnovers
extremely
for
good.
Tonga.
And at the other end, Palavi and Lee Jones, both players who can dominate the space there under the ring and are doing quite well.
They're doing quite well for both teams, Palavi and also Lee Jones there. The first quarter there. Tonga lead 16-11. We'll be back after the break.
Oh, back out for the second quarter.
We're back here, second quarter action, and it is Bryce trying to feed into the goal circle. Richters gets it, and defence trying to spoil. The shot doesn't stick, and it's taken away by Tonga.
I see they've made some changes there for defence in Tonga. They've put Claire Iongi back there in goal defence and put Los Fifita in wing defence. So there's a few changes there for the defence line of Tonga.
Yeah, they've left...
Good defense
back there at goalkeeper. It's like
again making her mark.
Bebe 1-2 with Iongi, and Bebe again into the front third. Now patiently building, and then to Bebe, and finally they find Pallavi. Now we had a discussion yesterday about number of caps, and I put you on. Question without notice.
I went home and did my homework. I knew you'd grill me again about it. So having spoken, like we talked about yesterday, Tonga came into the be a member of the World Netball in 2013. And before that, there pretty much wasn't anything on record. So having, from the records of Tonga being a member of the World Netball coming forward, the most capped player is Unique Pallavi.
Well, heavy fall there, just a tangle of legs. So, yeah, Unique Pallavi, and how many games she got? So she's been in the team since 2019.
Since 2019, Unique Pallavi has been playing for Tala together with Marie Hansen, also Luana Aukafolau, and Peti Tala Noa. But Unique has been playing every game since 2019. And having said that, she's the most capped player for Tala and the Tonga team with 24 games altogether.
24 games. So she's going to rack some up here this week.
She will.
A great opportunity because you have long periods. You said 2015 to 2019, you don't get too many internationals of a four-year period. So it's tough.
Was the usual, and it was hard to be counting back then. But then now with the Pacific Isles series and these competitions, they're gaining. So having said that, Pallavi at the moment with 24 caps.
Yeah, so she's going to end up, probably will pick up 5 or 6 caps in March at the series, and then some at the qualifier, and then again here she'll get another 6 caps in this tournament.
Glossa Whanganuku there once again. Yep. She is on fire tonight, Mike. Really making her presence felt here. Oh,
that's a bullet pass in under the post. And
some
Koloto.
Good eyes and Koloto out of nowhere because the defense were all on Pallavi. Oh.
And Delaney's read that and went for it. But just couldn't pull it in before it goes out over the sideline. So Bebe with a throw in. They go to Pallavi, and she gets the contact from behind by Delaney, so that will give her a shot at goal. And, well, I think she gets the ball anywhere in the circle, and she's likely to put it in through the net.
She was interviewed about her shooting, like, you know, what's the secret weapon? And she says she gets the ball, close her eyes, counts to 3, shoots.
Wonderful. Find your process, find the one that works, and keep doing it.
And it seems to be working well for her.
Well, she must do a fair amount of shooting practice. I mean, obviously, great natural talent, but you've got to hone that talent as well and work hard. Talent only
you wonder
gets
you
how
so many
far.
Shots a day.
Yeah, well, talent will get you so far, but the hard work will get you the rest of the way.
That's definitely right, and we can see that coming forward for the players here. Tonga lead 21 to 13, sorry.
And they're just controlling the tempo of the game now. Tonga really, those shutdowns in defensive end, and then conversion at the front between Pallavi and Koloto, who are deadly accurate at the moment.
Break in there from USC, which means turnover for Tonga.
Yeah, we talked about those coach killers, those unnecessary turnovers.
Disadvantage for that team, but an advantage for those who get the turnover like Dala there. and it makes the team that loses that ball, you have to work twice as hard to retain that back.
Yeah, it's almost a two-goal turnaround. So the skips out now 23-13, and they'll make it 24.
The beauty about games like this, Mike, for Tonga Tala, is that they, as we spoke about, get to further test the waters, especially playing with the club teams of Australia. They're familiar now, the clubs within the region of Oceania, having played against each other in March, again in July. But now with the introduction of teams such as USC and the Australian Pathway, it's a great attribute to testing the waters and the talent of the Oceania teams.
Yeah, a win today for Tonga will certainly guarantee them a spot into the gold medal final on Friday. They'll play Australian Pathway tomorrow, and their final game is against Samoa, who, depending on how they go, might be the likely matchup for Friday's final.
But then again, Mike, Samoa and Tonga are fixed to play Thursday, so that'll be interesting.
For me, they're going to play Thursday, and they may be the likely matchup for Friday for the final. But there's a little bit of netball to go here. We've got to get through the rest of the day. Samoa played PNG later today, and obviously this game here, Tonga up against USC.
But, great turnover there from USC. They were able to take that off Tonga Tala from the end. Bryce snatching that ball away and able to throw it back in.
Lee Jones goes over to Richters, who's now playing at goal attack. So it's going to restart by Bryce. That's an offside play against...
Call on Lee Jones there.
Yeah. That's a nice battle there. She's like, Fanganuka, get out of my road, but just a little bit too much that time. There goes over to Pallavi, and she's going to feed it outside. Picked off by Metcalf. Does well to get it back in court. Well, the ability to take it on the line, spin, and then throw an accurate pass is great skills.
Definitely great skills coming through from the girls of USC, and at a fast pace too.
And the Plua back over to Martin. Martin will look inside. And Richters with the first chance, gets the rebound. And finishes it off this time for 25-15. Pepe goes long. Pallavi's good for the catch. Lots of good positive talk too from both teams.
Having to come back to their centre pass, USC there. Good tip there from Losa Fifita defence. Gaining that ball, turnover for Tonga.
Just building. Down the centre court now. Patient build-up by Tonga. And we've got a motion call, I think, against Tonga there. Turnover.
Turnover for USC. Again, it's those hard decisions that have to be made within 3 seconds.
Martin, clock is running. Nearly picked off by Fafita. Gets it back and goes to Richters. Over the top to Lee Jones. And a little contact on Lee Jones. She'll get the shot. To make it 26-16. 10 goal deficit now for USC. Pallavi just always in the right place for the ball. Tough to watch her closely. She said she closed her eyes, counts to three and shoots.
She was interviewed in July, and they asked, you know, what's your secret? It doesn't matter which end of the court or which end of the goal that you're at, you manage to get it in. She says, I just catch the ball, close my eyes, count to three, look, and I shoot.
Yeah.
Oh.
Picked off there by Bryce. He's having a strong game for the USC. And Martin will get the free pass start. Bryce wants it. Rice looking to feed over Martin, and that one.
Good tip there from Fifita. USC ball. You know, the beauty of reaching out for stuff like that, Mike, is that despite you may not get the ball for your team, but you slow it down for the other team.
Yeah.
And, you know.
Well, they're spoiling here a couple of times. Fanganuku knocked one out. Whoa. And then that one's stolen by Bevy.
Bevy, it's just dangerous. It's like she times it and knows exactly when the ball is in the air, and she just goes up there and takes that ball down.
Down the court,
Fifita there. Oh.
Caught there just the extra step before she let the ball go.
Handling there, hold on USC. Will Tonga take advantage of this and take it all the way?
Oh, right on the line. And the foot went out, I think, before she just managed to release that pass.
And the umpire was in a good position to make that call.
A little contact there between two opponents, smile on their face, and the game continues. Lee Jones coming down the court, trying to play provider for Richters. And Fanganuku is still spoiling a lot of good ball into the USC goal circle.
She is making her mark, definitely. Seen there, and with a good combination, Fanganuku, Clay Yongi, and also Losa Fifita on defense.
McClure gets the turnover. So pinching one back here for USC. Martin sees Bryce down the court.
The pace of this game, Mike, as we can see, the two teams head-to-head in terms of fitness, as we can see. And the fast pace of the ball and movement of the game so far.
You know, again, the very impressive thing is the ability to make the decisions under pressure and stress with, you know, only seconds. Every time you've got the ball, you've got to look, think, make a decision and choose the correct option.
You've got 3 seconds to make that call.
Setafano tries to pick one off, and Bryce comes down the right side, and
again, Fanganuku still making that
just
spoil.
Spoiling. Yeah, it's spoiling. That's it. It slows it down, and it just means they don't get a shot this time. They're going to have to try and mount that attack again. Fanganuku will contest every single moment in this match. And is that an offside call?
Less than 3 minutes of the game, and Tonga lead 27-19 USC.
And Richters is going to go from range. And that one pops over the top, cleaned up by Fanganuku. Looks down the court, finds Yongi, and I'll mount their attack from the back here. Nice call from Yongi there, calling Fifita over for support. Now Bevy takes over in the middle third. Yongi again for Fifita, and nice lead ball into Pahlavi. Well, they make it look so easy with those connections. It's like the ball's on a string.
Reading each other well, and Pahlavi has her hand out. Give it to me.
Well, collision there between Bryce and Fifita, and both of them with a bit of a smile. Yeah, there's no malice in those. It's just simply eyes for the ball, and someone else's body in the way, you can't help but collide.
Ooh.
Oh, nice rugby pass there, but she goes right
didn't
back
see
to
that
USC.
Coming. Good defense. Fanganuku is really, really making her mark, Mike, as we see in both quarters so far. The turnovers that she's made, not only that, slowing down the ball process. Ooh. Oh, Bevy steals it back. Oh.
Kalota trying to play Pahlavi, and defenders doing their best to spoil. And Delaney, she's just a young kid there at the defence, doing her absolute best. And Pahlavi, a seasoned international.
Let's go.
inside the final minute of the half as Richter's to McClure, and they're getting very bunched up there now, USC.
Oh.
That one picked off and
lost that.
Well, she was...
Yep, and it goes.
It does stick, yeah.
Yep.
She was just desperate for the pass. Quieto to Pallavi, and Delaney is spoiling.
Oh.
Did well. Last touch there off Tonga. And Delaney getting the hand in there and just spoiling.
Woo. Oh. Good one. Veve there. She's dangerous. Do not do one of those long passes or high passes in front of Veve, Mike. She will take that ball.
Yeah, her... sort of lateral movement is just exceptional. She can change direction, go the other way.
And, it's just the way she plays.
Sprint.
Like,
yeah.
You know, she's right down there, and then next minute she's up there. Ooh.
Well, that's the end of the half, 31-19. Tongatawa, and again, Whanganuku doing the work from the back with Iongi and Fafita. And that,
I think that's a really great combination that they've worked there for the Tala. The defense line, Fifita Whanganuku and also Iongi.
Yep, they're going extremely well. Delaney working hard at the other end, trying to shut down Pallavi. She's got a big job on her hands. But we'll take the break for halftime. Be back in about 11 and a half minutes.
Matematoma, 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 matemat Tavengo waenga itala, talata ofa tu ihevava. Kavenga fola ukuo tu kufua, kavasa kipe ae ikuna. Otuo motonga atofi a, otokuo tongi atalo to itonga. Talakuo kapapuna heta moana, fatu kate nifako halofia.
Oh,
Umate maa tonga, umate maa tonga peri. Aluai, aluai, aua. Umate maa tonga, umate maa tonga peri.
Just a reminder that flash photography and live streaming from personal devices is not permitted in the venue. We are streaming live and free on Netball Australia TV all around the world. You can
in defence. She stole one on the back line and threw this rugby pass, and you said to me, well, she's got brothers that play rugby.
Lotsafang Nuku, she has the two brothers that I told you about, one in the All Blacks and one that was representing Tonga and the Ikaletahi. So no surprises there that she threw that rugby pass there during the netball match.
She might have done that in the backyard with the brothers on the odd occasion.
I see some changes there for Tonga's lineup in the shooters' end. Marie Hansen there. Marie Hansen together with Christina Oscar and
Oscar
Pallavi still in there.
So Oscar came on yesterday, had her first international for Tonga and was quite impressive.
Christina Oscar there at wing attack. Marie Hansen coming in as goal attack. Unique Pallavi still stays at goal shoot. In the defense line, we still have their Klee Iongi at goal defense. Lose Fanga Nuku at goalkeeper, and Lose Fifita at wing defense there. And of course, Captain Hulita Veve stays at center.
Richters and Lee Jones have continued their partnership. Now, Mukundi was on earlier and she's gone off, so hopefully that's not a sort of niggly injury for her. She came off the court reasonably early in the first quarter.
Some tussle there from the shooters and the defense there.
Well, that one doesn't...
Great call there from Claire Young. She just left that to go out.
Yeah.
Do I touch it? And it still goes out and the ball goes the other way?
Yeah, Lee Jones was reaching for it because she realised that, USC were the last one to touch it. We're right down the court very quickly here with Pallavi comes back to Bevy. Now, right back into the middle third. So, nice patient build-up here. Metcalf trying to spoil. One in, one back to Hansen. And Hansen... starts her quarter off, first time on the court in this match, and nice touch for her to get a goal. Well, the attention is over on Pallavi, and Hansen scrambling there. Delaney will take it to Metcalf, and looking for the releases. Small in the court also, and then he gets a steal.
Steals that back.
Pallavi thought about giving it back, and she'll now gets to step one forward. and doesn't roll in. Trying to get the rebound. That's off Tonga and gone out over the baseline. So restart now. Smalley, as I said, she's come into the game. Martin lays it off and goes to try and run a line, and they can't pick up Bryce, who was the target.
For those that have joined us, Tonga leads 34-19 USC. This is the host team playing with the Tonga Tala here. And for the viewers back from Tonga, the time there is 8:50 p.m., Mike, and I'm sure it's prime time back there, and there's a lot of viewers joining us supporting the Tonga Tala this hour.
Yeah, all the great fans of Tonga netball and all the families will be gathered around the TV sets. Lee Jones looking for an offload. Martin, and then that one out wide. Richter's and spoiled there by Tonga. Oyongi getting the hand on it. But
the pressure of the defense there has
that one's
been
up in
harsh.
The first row of the grandstand.
The ball's like, hey there, I want to take a...
get a better position. So
called out there for stepping. USC changeover, fast ball on Tonga there. 1-2 goal. Those are the scary moments, Mike, in terms of when the ball turns over to the next team.
Oh, that's a great one by Yongi. Oh, it goes back to Richter's, but Yongi's going to get the free pass.
Young there really making her presence felt.
Hansen has to go outside the circle. It's come back to Hansen.
Young, of course, has been named a training partner for the Swifts.
Oh, lovely. Okay. So that's a great opportunity for her to further her netball career and obviously further the overall performance of the Tongan team. One, two back inside, and just rolls over the top from Hansen.
The defense there.
Oscar trying to spoil. So Martin will leave it. Bryce goes around the outside, and they don't go back to her. Smalley. And Martin feeds in Lee Jones, who sees her shot partner, and Richter's coming in from the far side.
She gets the rebound too.
Yeah, good hustle under the post by the USC Thunder. 38-22. Martin over, and that's picked off.
Oh, oh, and it went in.
Fanga Nuku, fabulous play.
Now that's the kind of defense you do not want to be partnering with. Oh,
just a stepping call. Bevy took one more extra pace. Just the defensive pressure there forced that pass a little bit wide on Smalley. She couldn't take it. Oscar gives it inside to Hansen. There's a contact there, so comes to Pallavi. And that one sticks. And nice explanation there from our umpire, and Delaney just acknowledging, yep, okay, get
That's
it.
Really nice, right? You know how they make the calls and they give them the reason why, and then it continues on?
Yeah, game continues on, and Delaney was absorbing it and then nodded and said, yeah, okay, thank you, got it.
Whoa.
On over the top, Bryce takes it nicely. Smalley down the middle. Now, Martin's had a lot of touches in the game. It's a wing attack. Really injecting yourself into the game. And Yongi that
Some
time,
good defense
out of the
there.
Way, but it comes to Richter's. Well, sometimes the bounce of the ball can be lucky. Well, player just slipping over on the court there. So, step one further for Bryce, right on the circle, edge. Richter's rolls it in. 39-24. Oscar has to come in behind. Hansen didn't have a target in the center yet, so goes out to Oscar and presents herself again. So the contact was out the top of the circle. Delaney reaching in. And picked off there. Ooh, just won by Delaney, but picked off by Tonga again.
Marie Hansen there making that.
Well, that constant pressure and that drive into the passing lane to try and turn that ball over.
Tonga have been doing that so well, as you see the turnovers that they've had.
Bit of bumping there between Hansen and Smalley. Delaney one-handed, picks off Martin. And well, I can't control it, that's turned over again.
And Claire Yongi said, that's mine.
It's that desperation for the ball. The Tongans have great respect for their possession and desperation to get it when they don't have it.
Some good toss there between Claire Yongi and her partner.
Oh, that one slips through the hands, but finds Pallavi in the end, and she'll make no mistake.
For those that have just joined us, ooh, call there on USC, Tonga lead, Tala 42 with USC 24.
And of course, if you do come into the game late, you can obviously go back onto Netball Australia TV and watch a replay if you've missed some of the games earlier in the tournament. You want to see how your team is going. So we certainly are enjoying the pleasure of your company wherever you're watching right around the planet. And of course, huge numbers tuning in the Pacific Islands for this wonderful series.
We're into the third quarter. Less than 3 minutes of the third quarter left. As you said, Tonga leads 43-24.
Will to stop on the line there.
USC.
These girls have been playing netball for such amount of time that they're able to read the court, you know, almost off by heart. Like, they'll catch it in the air and they're like just at the edge, but they're still right in there.
Yeah, the inbuilt radar knows exactly where the sideline is.
And then, of course, there are moments where, you know, they'll continue on with the game. It'll be on the umpire if they've got that eye to make that call. Whanganuku again catching that and turning it over for Tonga. Are they able to take it all the way?
USC hustling in defence, trying to put pressure on Bevy. He does well to get to it. And nice low ball into Hansen. And one more to Pallavi, just getting closer to the post. Puts it away, and that nice little hand slap between the two of them, working beautifully as a partnership.
We can see the benches there raising for support to their team. USC turn over that ball there from Tongantala.
Well, Metcalf trying a one-hand pass over
good
the top.
Good defense. You know, the defense, it's all about slowing it down, spoiling it for that team who currently holds possession.
Yeah. Rice with the lead down the left side and picks out Richters, who manages to pull it in and gets her shot, rolls over the top, rebound to Lee Jones, puts it away.
This is our second. Oh,
Whanganuku getting up the spoil again.
Our second match for the for today. Our first one, of course, was Fiji and the Australian Pathway.
Australian Pathway side, won by the Australian Pathway, 58-34.
Great defense there from Claire Yongi. She stole the ball there.
Yongi over the top to Pallavi. Oh, plays off the post. That's one I haven't seen before.
How was that? Did you see that?
Yeah, he plays it off the post. I've not seen that.
She played it off well. Just that tip to the post, running up to it, catching it again.
So, because you can't play the ball to the ground and play it back to yourself. So she's played it off the post. And
she's played it off the post.
Yeah, yeah. Very smart play.
Very smart play and just getting her closer.
Well, pulling everything out of the bag of tricks there in the front line. Pallavi showing all her experience. And for a young athlete at 21, she's so experienced.
I think with all the you know, international games that she has played at a very young age, it's given her that confidence and just really being able to play to her full potential. And that brings us to the end of the third round with Tongatala leading with 45-27.
Yeah. Oh, 45-27. They put the last goal up. Yeah, that was a bit slow to go up. So 45-27 at the end of three. We'll take a break and have some words from our sponsors and our supporters, and we'll be back.
Seu que tem uma tarde, calvo que é um campo.
Fai a como e dimmi how. O tu fele ni te colau cau. Dala e o kuma fu.
And we're back underway here in the fourth stanza. It is 45-27, Tonga leading USC. They get the first attack of the game. Now, Lottie, Tonga Tala, what are the origins of the team name there, the Tala?
Mike, as you know, when the team came out in March, they were just known as Team Tonga, without a name. This is the first series that they've come out to. But during that time when the Tonga team played in March series, it was during some hard times for our country. We just had the volcanic eruption and also tsunami, followed with hard lockdowns of COVID during that time of that Pacific series. And the girls winning undefeated in the Pacific Odds series was a spirit lift for all our people worldwide and in Tonga. And in June this year, Tonga netball team was fortunate to have received this blessing from Her Majesty Queen Anaspau with the name Tala for the national team. And Tala is a bird. It's a rare bird when seen, which brings good omen. And pretty much that is what this team was for our people in March. And they're very honoured to carry this name, which was blessed by our Queen Anaspau.
Oh,
and they come out playing the Tongan Tala.
Yeah, it's a wonderful story, and it'll go forward in history and be well revered to be a member of the Tala. Will be a huge honour.
Exactly. We have some changes there for Tonga. In shooting, we don't see a unique Pahlavi there, but the other Pahlavi, Beyonce Pahlavi, she's on at gold attack. Marie Hansen moved to gold shoot. We also have Celia Stefano coming in at wing attack. Also some changes in the defense. We have Peti Talanoa coming in at gold keep. Halaivalu Toteolepo at gold defense. And
nice block there from Talanoa. Lee Jones stays as the goal shooter for the USC Thunder.
We see Veve is taking the bench, and Christina Oscar is moved to centre, while Losa Fifita to wing defence.
Yeah, Jeffrey on now also for USC Thunder as wing defence. Lovely shot there.
Great shot from there from Lee Johns. Bringing the score, Tonga Tala, to 48-31 USC.
And as you were beginning to say before, we'll stick with the action for the moment, but the Tala being a very rare bird, so not seen very often, and as you said, it symbolises a blessing. And
so in terms of fishing context, when the bird Tala is seen, it's an area where there's a lot of fish, so it sends that sign out to the fishermen. And in that context, the Tala also, when seen, it's hope and brings good fortune. So in that context, that is what this team was for our nation.
Hope
during
and good fortune.
During hard times in March when the Pacific Series was happening.
Well, that is a beautiful story, and thank you for sharing it with
everyone
watching.
No, you're most welcome. Yeah.
Setafano looking for a feed into the centre circle for Beyonce Pahlavi.
Just a little short there.
Yeah, Delaney did well to pick it off on the rebound. And quick down the court here. Richters looked inside for Lee Jones, who's had a really solid game here for USC. And probably just rewards there for Faye Ngunuku and Unique Pahlavi getting rest after really solid performances for three quarters of the game. They want to probably save their legs for later in the tournament.
Later in the tournament, they've got two more games.
Yeah, so Tonga will take on the Australian Pathway team tomorrow, and then they'll round out the tournament on Thursday as our last game, late game Tonga-Samoa. And, well, we've still got to wait for other games to play and the way that pans out, but it might likely be a preview of the final.
We'll see how it goes, and at the moment, Samoa hasn't lost any of their games too, right?
Samoa knocked over the Australian Pathway on the first day, and then they beat Fiji on day two, so they come in here as the other undefeated side tonight against Papua New Guinea.
And it most likely, if we continue on that way, it will most likely be those two teams, the Tonga Tala and Tifa Samoa, that will head on to the finals, which will be happening Friday. Good tip there from Christina Oscar, slowing things down there, but USC still have the ball.
Richter's under the post.
I know Coach Jacques Porimakia Simpson is exploring the players there and resting some of the players. Some contesting there happening on court.
Good smile on the face, but I go forward here and it's going to be Hansen.
Some good netball rivalry there happening on court. At the end of the day, the whistle rules.
Yeah. Smalley to Martin. And
I think Lee Jones has been called out there. Turnover for Tonga.
Oh, just slipped out of the hands of Oscar. And on over the top. And again,
that's the second call for Lee Jones there on this quarter.
Yeah, and impressive too. Like, should be disappointed to get those calls against her, but she just gives the ball back and on we go. There's no time to linger on anything in this game. It happens too quickly.
It just happens too quickly. You've got 3 seconds. Make it or break it during that three. Let go.
Well, certainly Delaney's got a bit of a height advantage at the moment, but they're getting good ball in there for both Hansen and Beyonce Pahlavi.
A lot of noise happening on court there.
Yep. Lee Jones, and that time the free throw sticks with her, and the Richters will put it away.
Come on,
So it's important here, and certainly they're not doing it, but for Tonga not to shut up shop. They're 52-36 to the good, but they've got to keep playing because it can change very, very quickly.
It can, and as you can see, the USC team, they're not slowing down.
No.
So, you know, Tonga has to keep that up one for one just to keep that lead because USC is not slowing down. Also, we can see our supporters from the Pacific and also the families of the USC players and also the Australian pathway coming through to support the teams throughout the week, which is really nice. And for all those that are near this area, Sippy Downs, USC Sports Stadium, come on down. The games start 3 o'clock every day with the last round of games happening at 7 p.m.
Yeah, 3, 5 and 7 are our start times for each match.
Martin there at wing attack, she's really good and fast pace, Mike.
Yeah, she's been working hard the whole way, and Delaney there nearly getting the turnover, and she wins it.
Oh, good contest there from Marie Hansen.
Yeah.
Managing to turn that ball back for Tala.
And I'm glad they've got good stopping power and turning power because she was about to end up right in our lap here in the commentary
That's
position.
Right. USC turn over that ball once again.
Oh,
just a little
Martin
too much.
Didn't need to reach for it. Richter's, I think, had it covered. Nice ball in.
Gets Beyonce Pahlavi there, she threw it and ran right under the court there and got that ball.
She got a really nice cheer from the bench as well.
That's right, her sister cheering her on there together with the bench.
And I think the other thing I've noticed about the Tongan team, they look like they're having fun. They've always got beautiful smiles and they're always upbeat. And you see them coming out of the stadium, they're all upbeat.
They're a good bunch, Mike. They're lovely to have on and off the court, always smiling, like you said, and just really much having fun amongst each other, as you see there. The other thing, we also want to send a shout out to the families who are coming through, driving in from...
some from Brisbane.
Brisbane.
Yeah, from around the local area.
Yes,
yeah.
That are driving in to support their families. The captain's family, Julita Veve, they're here. Her husband and children, also her mother, which I want to shout out. It's her mother's birthday today.
Oh, happy birthday.
Yes, and the team, I think, they celebrated that.
Oh, the combinations are still really slick here for Tonga. It's impressive stuff.
With the shooting line coming in, Marie Hansen, Beyonce Pahlavi, it looks like you said, the combination is fixed well.
Setafano, 1-2 back in. Pahlavi turns and now she gets a free shot.
That's a bonus for those two, the Pahlavi sisters, to be playing together in Tala. Their father, Steve, is with us here following their games around.
He said he's here? Or he's...
He's here.
Oh, he's here.
He's
okay.
Here.
Yeah.
They're in Melbourne, but
yeah.
The father's...
Just a contest for the ball. Martin That's goes down, but the ball will stay with Tonga. Well, it hasn't backed off. The desire to win the ball hasn't backed off the entire
it
game.
Hasn't. And it hasn't. And we're into the fourth quarter.
That
Less than
off.
3 minutes.
Well,
what,
USC
fourth quarter. And it's nice to see that up to the very last whistle that both teams are still... Tonga take that ball.
Delaney trying to get in and spoil. And
she's one.
She'll get the pass. 56-38 inside the last 2 minutes.
Good cross there from Lossa Fifita. She read that ball coming that distance and she crossed it and managed to win that over for Tonga. Fast ball there to Marie Hansen and she shoots it in.
Yeah. I'm going to say that desire to win the ball hasn't dropped off. I'm going to say it's even got more intense here in the fourth quarter.
It has, as you know, some of the players have just gotten on, so they're, you know, they're just
they
making
make
their mark.
They're making
they
make
their
mark. Yeah. That one over with Oscar. So your players that have come and had their international debuts for Tonga, what are their backgrounds? Are they based in Tonga or are they based overseas?
So three players that are debutants on this game here. We've got Christina Oscar, Celia Stefano, and also Lossa Fifita. They're all based in New Zealand,
right?
Different parts of New Zealand. Invercargill for Lossa Fifita, Auckland for Christina Oscar, and also Wellington for Celia.
So they would come up against each other in the New Zealand competition
they
from time to time?
They do,
yeah. So rivals to become teammates.
That's our story. Ooh.
Nice 19
seconds.
Beautiful one-handed pass in there. And that came from out in the middle third. And with 4 seconds to go, Lee Jones might finish the game off for us. And that one doesn't stick. But that is the end of the contest.
59 to Tongatala and 39 USC, the home host there. What a game, Mike.
Oh, fabulous game. Tonga continue undefeated in the tournament and they continue to look like the team to beat.
They do. You know, the team is looking good, and I'd have to give credit to Jaco Porimakia Simpson and also Brian Aiko, the specialist coach. We have them in good hands of two physios, Van Nugent and also Tiana Mosca. So kudos to all the support that the Team Tonga is getting, and you could see that with them on the court.
Well, stick with us because we've got the other undefeated team in the tournament here, Samoa, taking on PNG, who could become the big spoilers.
It'll be an interesting game. I'm sure both teams went, Samoa, of course, celebrated their win over Fiji, but the PNG Pepes had gone back, you know, did some review, drawing board, and it'll be some good game to watch.
Well, they can spoil here because Samoa with a victory again, they should probably book a spot in the final, but PNG will be trying to spoil.
Having said that, we're rounding up. I just want to send a shout out to all the viewers back at home, Mike. They're telecasting this on the state television, Radio and Television Tonga, and also on Broadcom 87.5. Thank you to all the supporters and the messages that have come through to all the teams of the Pacific. They are coming through. Malo au pito ho mo mea mai, tautou whitau laki taim tatau pongpongi. Thank you very much, Mike.
Yeah. πας, κολοσσίο νοβάιβα. Κάτι φαινίντα σε πίσε αφάωα. Πε του κουπουλού ατούλη και δε μαλά εω αφακαού ένα σε ουγέ. Τεωματά ε καου φωκία μου. Καου φάει από μω έτοιμη χαου. Ότου φελένιτε κολλάου καου. Καλά πε όπου μαθού.
Come on, 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 come on